Okay, we're gonna head out for the ride. This is my usual route to work out, to run. This is along Vitayu Road. As much as possible, I do try to cycle on the path. Can. Sunday morning, so usually the street will be empty, rather, there's not much traffic. Okay, I gotta head over to the other side. This is a one-way road. Right in front of me is the BTS station. Station Phalit is over there. And that's where I commute daily. Okay, so it's going towards that direction. My daily route to work. Here, you gotta look left, look right, look front, look back, because traffic can come from everywhere. Not from the car, but basically the bike. You'll be traveling all over different directions. Even against the traffic on the pavement. Another central. And yeah, we are at Chitlong station. Right ahead. Okay, so it's green here. And let's see if they stop. See? They don't stop even though it's green. right? So you have to wait for them to let you go, or you can just go and make sure that, or hoping that they stop for you. Okay. So even though green man doesn't mean that you always have the right of way, it is what it is here. So you gotta live with it. Junction, you can see that's the downtown central Chitlom, and this is Mercury, another mall. Okay, green, and still better to check the right to make sure that there's no car turning left and hit you, even though it's green. Marine mall on my left. And in fact, I hardly walk into any mall actually when I'm here, except to the supermarket. Okay, so ahead of me, Siam Station, BTS train, nicely designed, and yep, my usual weekend routine, I will come to the temple and pray, and I will just park my bike here. Okay, so prayer is done and I'm getting out again. Thank you. track if I record. Sometimes I will just forget to press the record button. I will just keep going and going and then realize at the end of the day, nothing has been recorded. So in front of me is the Rajaratnapuram BTS station, and that's the Siloam line going towards the Chopraya River. I actually like to cycle, you know, on the pavement. I'm not a road person because I'm not really confident in cycling on the road. But the problem is that the pavement here, you can see they are made up of small little tiles and very uneven. The cycling over here is really bumpy. And at times you can see, you know, potholes, and you really have to, you know, keep your eyes open. And yeah, to a certain extent, no choice that I have to really head out to the road. Yep. You can see here in front of me is a cycling path. I don't know why it just starts there or stops there. Maybe they don't have budget or, you know, just stop building it, right? It's a cycling path. I like this, like what we had in our PCN in Singapore. Smooth. A couple of times in this area. Is the Thai Red Cross Research Center. carry on to the bicycle park. And not sure if I can squeeze through. Yes, I can. Yep, made it. Oh, there's some work going on there. Right, just where I'm looking at right now, where I'm pointing. Okay, that's the Lumpini Park. Okay, you can check out my previous video where I actually ran at Lumpini Park. Long Kong Hospital on my right. Sunday morning, moderate traffic over here, and yeah, I realized there's not many cyclists here in Bangkok. Yeah, just when I was talking, I see one in front, but not as much as what we see in our Singapore, where always a group of cyclists you encounter regularly. But here, I guess it's not, well, I am not too sure, not very cycle friendly. And in fact, the road, okay, the road is, the marking is pretty narrow, and I realized a lot of bikes and even cars like to drive very near to the curb. And that's one thing that I'm quite worried, and then I don't have the skill to right along the road. Okay, so let's get across the road here. There's no green man, no red man, so we just have to make sure that the traffic light is red, not in their favor, and it just cross. Right? In this case, right, if you look at it, if the traffic light is green, it means yeah, they are actually moving. Even though there's stripes over here for crossing, but apparently there's no green man or pedestrian walking light. So you have to learn to survive and probably learn about the traffic over here. Just a while to get used to. And yep. So even though this is straight, but the other side is green. Alright, so it's like one direction at a time. So if that side is green, that means they can go straight or they can go right. So you also try, so you also cannot cross. Even if you cross, those cars turning right, they might hit bang into you, and then this pillar is actually blocking them, creating a blind spot. So the best bet is wait for this car to move. They can turn left, but at least they are not fast. Or you can follow this gentleman over here. If he cross, you cross. In the case of monkey see, monkey do. Okay. BTS station, Saladang. And usually on weekdays, this area is actually very crowded. Okay, because a lot of offices are here, and weekdays people go to work, and you can actually see quite a number of street stalls selling breakfast, food, you know, to cater for the people who are working. But currently, due to the COVID, the numbers are high, and the government actually encourage, but they don't enforce, right? But they encourage, you know, to everybody to work from home. And yeah, the office workers are getting lesser, so even on the weekdays, you don't really see much people. But yeah, usually weekdays really crowded, weekend quiet. Just like our Raffles Place, Shenton Way. Of green man, Grab driver, rider, food vendor. Okay, this is the time that they get very busy because the government here has imposed 30 days no dine-in. So the only thing you can do is take away or for food vendor, Grab online. Right, they have this line man. Right, line is the message app that we use, but over here you can actually use line for food delivery or any other delivery. Okay, empty street. My previous video, I've actually ran here before, and this is Soi Hak Hong, once busy street, once now become so quiet. I've been here many years ago, right, because there's a night market over here, but never once I would dream that I'll be able to cycle right in the middle of a road here. Well, not a good thing anyway. It's affecting the country's economy. So yep, hope everything will pick up back to normal pretty soon. Street food stalls, common sight here. Okay, is this a family mart? Okay, I'm thirsty. I actually want to grab some drinks.
Hello, welcome.
Hey. Okay, just got to see. I just need water actually, but I don't have enough cash. Shit. Okay. I've got to go. Okay, you can see over here in the family mart I was mentioning yesterday. You can see all these electrolytes, curry, water and stuff like that. It's easily available if you need to get one. So usually I will just grab a drink. This is actually electrolytes. See? Just grab a water. So thirsty. Okay. Let's see if they accept any kind of other payment. scan ได้ไหม
ไม่ได้
So I managed to get a water. Okay, seriously, I'm still not sure where I will be going. Should I just ride anywhere, any path, and if I see anything interesting, I will just stop and explore. The electrolytes, 13 baht, about 50 cents. But I don't know if this is good. I've tried them many times. So far, never had any issue with this. It tastes really good as well. Sure. Best. Bought this bicycle phone holder yesterday. It's quite useful. Only about $4 for this. Okay, let's continue. Keep riding. You see, I also don't know where I am and where this location. But Let's go. Oh, okay. If I'm not wrong, probably I know. If I ran here before, I'm not wrong. Okay, okay, there's a bus. I wanted to go out. Okay, the bus has stopped. Okay, just head out to the road. Go to the side. Smoother to ride along the road, but still, you know, there are some areas where they are pretty bumpy, some potholes over here. You see some all this uneven ground. Probably if you are on a mountain bike, it shouldn't be too much of an issue with the suspension. I'm on the Phalit. It can be one hell of a bumpy ride. Okay, green. Even though it's green at our favor, okay, if it's green at the advantage of favor, I think still you need to be very alert and look out for cars. Okay, if you remember the crab sign board, I think it's seafood. I don't know where it is right now. Okay. Okay, if you realize there's actually this line along the road. It's not for parking anyway. This line over here is for cyclists. This is actually a cyclist path below here. And during the weekdays, there are a lot of people who will just park beside here, and then they will get their wheel locked by the police. I'm supposed to go straight, and then the guy just turned left. So there's no such thing as giving way. So you need to be very, very careful. You look at the bicycle sign over here. Yep, it's actually a bicycle route that is meant for cyclists. But having said, yep, there are still some very, you know, nice drivers and, you know, bikers that will still give way, even though you are, you know, I'm crossing, you know, the road illegally. Okay, this is a station, Tong Nong Si, where I work. Okay, this is the path that I take every day to office. And that's my office. You can see the stand chart logo right above. Okay, this is where I come to buy my lunch, my food. Okay, this is my way I enter. It's my office here, right up there at level 19. Okay, I do come to the office every day. And because the rest of my colleagues are actually working from home, and we do keep a distance, so to say. Okay. Right, okay, this. And okay, this needs to go over to the other side. Something that I can do. Okay, this car is coming. I'm just gonna beat him to it. Okay. I ran along the BTS line in my previous video, but coming from that direction, so now I'm heading towards the opposite direction. Lots of things and lots of things to explore along the BTS line. San Luis Station. there are very few patients with English name, and this is one of them, St. Louis. Not sure why it's called St. Louis. Okay, we are approaching the Sepan Taksin station where the pier is. I've rode here before, so I don't think I will just proceed. I won't think I'll be proceeding there. You can actually see it from my previous video. Okay, so that's where the central pier is. And that's the actually the bigger river taxi, not the one that we went on my previous video and on the Klong. This is massive. Okay, so I just have to follow this lady. No, just have to. That's so nice of them. Thank you. See, although even if they are right away, but the the center point, not our center point in Orchard. Okay, you can see some of this rider, you know, sometimes they'll just stop, they'll just turn, you know, they'll just suddenly change lane. I think it's because the place, they are probably not too familiar, even though, you know, they might be living here, some of them, they might be doing the delivery every day, but still, you know, there's so many lane over here, so many food stalls. It can be really confusing, right? So it's, I won't say it's part of their job, right? It's just that when they see, oh, that's the place, and then they'll just suddenly turn. You know, to them, you know, time is money. And some of the customers can be really demanding, you know, and they are a bit late, you know, in terms of, you know, getting your food, the food delivery, they'll make noise. So, yep, understand, you know, what this Grab or Foodpanda or Lineman are going through delivering your food. So, you know, we can actually exercise a little bit more patience with them. I don't know where I am. Just keep talking and talking, and suddenly I'm at this quiet. Yeah, I think I probably might run here before, might have ran here before. I guess so, I think so. So otherwise, yeah, it looks familiar. But the road here actually, everywhere looks familiar to me. That's the, if I'm not wrong, the National Telecom Public Company Limited. This is the Grand Poster Building. This is like our SingPost. Very nice. Okay, I better keep my eyes on the road. Everywhere, anyhow. Gonna make a turn over here to see what it is. See, they're usually very close. They like to ride or drive very close to the curb. This quiet part of Bangkok. Maybe is it because it's weekend? I'm not sure. Maybe weekdays will be more people. Never had a chance to explore anything on the weekdays anyway. My run, my cycle, my right. So I always done over the weekend. Unless if there's some work, some job that I need to do. Otherwise, yep. Really kill my time. Just going around. Okay, especially when dine-in is not allowed, then you probably won't see too many people, because everybody is either cooking at home or just grab their food fast and head back home, or simply call for delivery. It makes a lot of difference, you know, buying back and dining in. Apparently, I think the restaurant or the food stalls do not need extra manpower to be manning the restaurant or stall, and that's where probably you see lesser people going to work, and some even don't offer takeaway. Okay, I remember this place. And then to the right is the Ratchathawi. To the left, now here. Okay, looks familiar to me. It's very huge. Yeah, there's so many lanes. Eight lanes. Very nice temple, and I think I see a very familiar landmark, a sign in front, and I think I know where I am. Do you know? It's a very nice temple. Wow. Okay, look at the front. This. Okay, this is a very sign, it's a very familiar sign to me. And I know where are we. You can guess it. It's got a okay, it's a roundabout. Back to where I always go, Yawarat. Been here a couple of times. Always like it here. I don't know why. Just maybe it's Chinatown. See the food that I like. Chinese wordings. And not only that, I think it's also, you know, very lively. Got more people coming to do their marketing, buying food. Not as quiet. looking for food. Haven't go to the ATM. If I need to buy something on the street stall, I will definitely need cash. So let's look for ATM. Okay, so just now I was at this Yawarat, and now I'm at this soy Phalit Phon. Phalit Phon. Still not good at pronouncing the words. But yep, apparently it's a market. Lots of shops selling masks, alcohol, sanitizer. Hair clips. Okay. Yeah, I guess currently the best selling stuff are the masks. Toys. Orange juice. Bags, more mask again. Okay, if you like skateboard. I think it's about the same. Let's head back out again. It's near to Chinatown. One of this soy, one of these streets over here. Get some really good, value for money stuff. Alright, I won't say valuable, sorry. Got the mask. Okay, trying to see what can I get for my little one. Probably too simple for them. I think such toys are probably, you know, not something that might excite them. Thank you. Okay, let's continue to explore further. It seems like there's something across the road. Maybe I can just walk over. Let's wait for my chance or an opportunity to see if I can walk over. Over here.
Oh, yeah.
Some actually have the shop front with them. Well, I think most actually have the shop front. Except for this, yep. They just set up their stall in front of the shop that are apparently closed. A lot of masks over here. Wallet. I might need a new wallet too. Back. Kitchenware, glasses, purse. More toys. Bananas! Okay, in front. More toys. Spider Man. More household stuff. Alright, just gonna head back there to grab my bicycle, or else I'll be walking further and further away. Okay, I rode past this place a few times. At first, I thought it's a stadium, but it looks like, you know, inside there's some shop and there's a track. But let's go and check it out. What is this? Say Stadium 1. There's this track over here, because I've always been riding opposite, and I kept thinking that this is a stadium. Burpees, mountain climbers, how to play, circuit workout game, burpees 20 seconds, jumping jack, quite interesting. This is a place for people to do workout. Not sure, but yeah. I think there's some, yeah, I think there's sport related shop, quite nice. But they put a track here, but they didn't actually have a slope. Oh, okay. And then there's a slope here. But then when you go up, you need to take a staircase. Okay. Anyway. Okay, looks nice. Sport Society, Stadium 1. Bubble tea. Mizuno. This is the car park area. It's pretty huge. Is this a place where people can do their workout? Not sure. Just a bit lazy to walk. Some gym over here. Clinic. Just cycle around here. I don't think there'll be people working out here. Maybe yes. Now it's actually midday. Let's see. Looks like a studio, a gym. And it stops here. Looks like a gym to me. Or they are selling gym equipment. It's a clinic. And I'm not sure due to what. It's closed here. It's a fitness center. A gym, I guess. It's a hair studio. Laundry. Okay, looks nice. It's over here. Active box. A Muay Thai studio. Jet 24 hour fitness. I think that's about it. Okay, never really quite explore much, but yeah, maybe there's something happening upstairs at the second level. But so it's not a stadium, which I misunderstood. Most important. Nice food over here. Ice cream. It's a bun. Path. better head out to the side of the road. Better, easier. Pigeon, pigeon. Okay, that's the National Stadium. Station BTS. Right ahead. Center. On my right is MBK. And it's green. Approaching Siam BTS station. Okay, I'm back. Back home. Gonna have my lunch, wash up, and relax for the next half of my Sunday.